So we continue to wait for the hatches to be officially opened between the Expedition 28 and STS-135 crews. You can see all the members of Expedition 28 there. Satoshi Furukawa there coming toward the camera. As we mentioned, there's a series of procedures that the crew has to do to get these hatches open. They've opened the pressurized mating adapter number 2 hatch. The next step is the actual main hatch in between the two crews, and that will signal our official hatch opening time.
Station on 2 for comm config.
Go ahead, Satoshi.
Houston, Atlanta, sign, Energon 2 for 2.10.
Hey, Rob, I am in step 4 of 6.109er, hotline ICOM audio. And it says ISS audio configuration must be complete prior to next step. That does it mean I need to do it on PCS?
That's good, Rex. You have a go to continue.
Okay, copy. Copy the question, stand by.
Roger.
And Satoshi, we have done all of our steps for the ground prep for this procedure. You are going to press into your assigned steps.
Okay, that means comm check with Atlantis.
Hey, station on the big loop, no need to reply. We're going to hit a hatch opening now.
And Satoshi, our understanding is that hardline audio comm check was already performed and it was partially successful only one way from ISS to shuttle.
That's affirmative.
Houston Atlantis on Willis on that discovery.
Go ahead, Rex.
Yeah, I did step one. That worked great. Step two, I've got everything except under backup mode selection. Primary is grayed out right now. Only secondary and standard are...
Checking. Okay, Rex, we only need you to do step one of the WLES dock undock recovery procedure.
Okay, great. That's complete then.
Thanks. Houston on the big loop, we're ready for free on the deck.
Copy that.
the next suit, Sergey.
September, I'm on board now. September, on the chance. Fish dial, Aris, on. On. Fish dial, Aris, on.
Copy, we see that, thanks.
This is Mission Control Houston. As you can see, the hatches are open between the shuttle and the station. We're just standing by for the two crews to greet one another. There's still some work that has to be done to install some ventilation in between the shuttle and the station itself. But our official hatch opening time was at 11:47 a.m. Central Time. So once again, official hatch opening time, 11:47 a.m. Central Time, according to the flight controllers here in Mission Control.
Zoom out to the original video. Record it. Push to record. Push to start recording. Interchanges of lighting and subject is in the recorder. Focus on the computer is adjusted. Push button red. Push to stop recording. The activation is ready. Right?
Ready? 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 Ready?
see the Expedition 28 crew there taking some pictures. As you can tell, it's not only a historic event for us here on the ground, but also for the crew. There is Commander Chris Ferguson of STS-135. Making his way on board the International Space Station. He is greeting the Expedition 28 Commander Andrei Borisenko.
Hey, Sergei, how are you?
I'm good.
Good to see you. Hey. Oh, my goodness, my long-lost Japanese friend. How you doing, buddy? Big Mike. How you, bud?
Good, man.
The pilot Doug Hurley making his way on board as well as with the camera, documenting this historic occasion. Rex Walheim and Sandy Magnus also floating their way up through the hatches as well. So the entire STS-135 crew now on board the International Space Station. We'll stand by, listen to these crews greet one another.
Sandy simply couldn't wait to get over here.
I know, it's like being home, except it's bigger.
Yeah, that's it.
So, did you guys know the shuttle was
going
to catch up?
You yourself jumping, you spell it. Expedition 28 Commander Andrei Borisenko is going to have a quick safety briefing with the crew of Atlantis. This is standard protocol anytime a shuttle docks with the station. Even though Sandy Magnus and the rest of the crew have been on board the station before, they have to get an update on the procedures and the unlikely event that there's an emergency on board. Also get familiar with the location of everything on board the station as well. So Expedition 28 Commander Borisenko will take care of this over the next several minutes, and then we'll continue to follow along as the crews say hello to one another.
Hey, record before we leave. Right behind Chunky there on the top of the hatch there, underneath that green cover is the tools and the standoff cross in the case of the vehicle. That's where it's just a little bit. There's an hatch door right. So we're gonna clear Satoshi off.
Oh wait, video. Gosh, how hard is it? Hook up your hookups to it. Cause I want to clear Satoshi off to start trying to troubleshoot the video. And if we were in that
vehicle. Did it?
They were
covering your live right live.
What the hell's up with that?
Yeah.
Couldn't believe that.
No, it was, we're like, oh my God.
I couldn't believe that.
So are you guys going out live right now on any of your cameras?
Yep, like, all of them.
All of them? Okay. So we're live to the ground, boys and girls.
I smile like.
This is Mission Control Houston. Once again, the hatches are officially opened at 11:47 a.m. Central Time today. The entire STS-135 crew now on board the International Space Station. They're going to get familiar with their surroundings. And then they will step into these robotics operations with the orbiter boom sensor system survey attachment handoff that's going to occur.